Those words were written by a supreme lyricist, Alan J. Lerner. Alan was what you'd call a Renaissance man. Aside from writing lyrics, he was a librettist, a screenwriter, an essayist, an author, a wit, a rascal, and for the last few years of his life, he was my husband. We met, actually, funnily enough, through one of Alan's shows, a show you may have heard of, a thing called My Fair Lady. I was playing the titular Fair Lady in Cameron Mackintosh's production, which was touring the provinces in England. And Cameron wanted to bring it into the West End, and so he asked Alan to redirect it, which he did. Alan and I, during the London rehearsals, became fast, fast friends and would spend many nights after work chewing the fat. So, when he invited me to the Savoy Grill for dinner, it never occurred to me to think of any kind of amorous liaison. But one dinner led to another, and then another. And by the time previews were on, I realized my feelings were more than platonic. Now, this was a disaster. Absolute sheer lunacy. I'm British. He was American. I'm 5'8". He was 5'6". I had never smoked in my life. He smoked like a chimney. I was 25. He was 25. Plus 36. What can I say about his face? Except the features are in place. He doesn't even look in trim. Why him? Why him? A million stars are in the skies. Not one is ever in his eyes. When I'm alone at night, I groan at night. Why him? Why do I dress for him? Why the hell of eating less for him? Why do I itch for him? Have an eyelid with a twitch for him? When I see him coming near me, and my head begins to swim, I keep on thinking as I nod, my God, why him? There's nothing bulging in his arm. I'm not bewildered by his charm. Where he should be, he isn't slim. Why him? Find him in a crowd. There is no lining to his cloud. I rack my brain at night in vain. At night, why him? I've never laughed with him. It's like standing in a draft with him. I'd put a knife in him just to see if there is life in him. If he's a knight in shining armor, then my vision's growing dim. I know I prayed there'd be a man somewhere who'd hear my prayer. But Lord, be fair, why him? Why him? Collaboration with Burton Lane, and it comes from a show called Carmelina. Now, just for your information, and a little kind of nice little fact thing, Carmelina had exactly the same plot as Mamma Mia. Carmelina came first. Doesn't have the ABBA songs, though. There you go. Alan J. Lerner and Burton Lane first collaborated on a film starring Fred Astaire and Jane Powell called Royal Wedding, Do you remember that scene of Fred, you know, dancing across the ceiling? Well, that's the movie. Okay. 15 years later, they met again and did the score of On a Clear Day You Can See Forever. And then when the musical was rejigged into a film for a movie vehicle for Barbara Streisand, new songs were added expressly for her. This next song you're going to hear, Love With All the Trimmings, comes from the film. And the other song, Love Before Breakfast, comes from Carmelina. My dearest love, who existed in a dream till this evening, when a wave came and swept me out to sea. None of the loves that you have known could prepare you for the love raging everywhere in me. For all the arms that have covered you, the hands that have touched you, and the lips you have lingered on before, added together would be less than an olive in the banquet of love I have in store. Love season to entice, love with all the trimmings filled with spice, love flavor to your whim, served piping hot with all the trimmings. Love before breakfast, arms that I slept in, tingle and tell me that morning has crept in. No hurried goodbye, too long have I wakened without you. Love before breakfast is the cloud we'll go sailing away on. It's the air we'll be walking all day on, and the smile only we can see. Love before breakfast, morning comes stealing, you on my pillow, joy with no ceiling. Songs written by Alan and Burton Lane, but on Thursday, when I'm performing at Don't Tell Mamas, in a show called Lerner Without Loewe, it's a tribute to all the other gents Alan collaborated with when he wasn't working with Frederick Loewe. So you'll hear songs written by Lenny Bernstein, Charles Strauss, Kurt Vile, Andre Previn. It's quite a collection, and we're very pleased with it, aren't we, Mark?
Oh, yeah.
So I hope we're going to see you there. Now, I've got a great story about Alan. I was starring in My Fair Lady in London, and Alan, one night during the course of the show, wants to go back home, and it was pouring with rain and it was dark, and had his hand outside the theatre and was waving down cabs and all going by with their lights off. And anyway, one finally pulled over with his light off and wound down the window and said, "Mr. Lerner, I know who you are, and please, it'd be my pleasure to give you a lift wherever you want to go." So Alan said, "Oh, that's very kind of you," and got in the car, and they set off, and the driver said, "Mr. Lerner, I hope you don't mind if I tell you something." And Alan said, "No." He said, "Well, from a block away, I knew it was you. But from two blocks away, I thought you were Sammy Davis Jr." Why do I mention his name? It's because he made this song a hit. Hear my voice where you are. Take a train, steal a car, hop a freight, grab a star, come back to me, catch a plane, catch a breeze, on your hands, on your knees, swim or fly, only please come back to me. On a mule, in a jet, with your hair in a net, in a towel wringing wet, I don't care, this is where you should be. From the hills, from the shore, ride the wind to my door, turn the highway to dust, break the law if you must, move the world only just, blast your hide, hear me call, must I fight City Hall, here and now, damn it all, come back to me. What on earth must I do? Scream and yell till I'm blue. Curse your soul, when will you come back to me? Have you gone to the moon or the corner saloon? And to rack and to ruin, who can tell where in hell you can be? Leave a sign on your door, lunch evermore. Hear my voice through the din. Feel the waves on your skin like a call from within. Come back to me. Leave behind all you own. Tell your flowers you will phone. Let your dog walk alone. Come back to me. Let your tub overflow. If a date waits below, let her wait for Godot. Ride a rail, come by mail, COD. Come in pain or in joy, as a girl, as a boy, in a bag or a trunk, in a horse or a drunk. Times and I absolutely adore him. But this lovely man here, Rit Hen, I met him for the first time 2 minutes ago. Hasn't he done a wonderful job? Thank you, sir. Thank you, Mark.
Go see them at Don't Tell Mama Thursday night at 7:30.